स्टैंडर्ड रेल सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 2 एनवायरमेंटल पोल्यूशन पार्ट 2। इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी विल लर्न अबाउट वाटर पोल्यूशन, हाउ वाटर पोल्यूशन कॉजेस, व्हाट आर इट्स इफेक्ट्स ऑन ह्यूमन लाइफ एंड एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स एंड हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ वाटर पोल्यूशन। नाउ सेकंड इज एयर पोल्यूशन। एयर पोल्यूशन दैट मीन्स एटमोस्फेयर। वी need oxygen to sustain our life, and oxygen we can get it from the atmosphere, which is the third and most important sphere on the earth. As water is necessary, air is also necessary to sustain our life. But with the rapid increase of industries, vehicles and many other technologies, it creates air pollution. The smoke and gas emitted by industries mix with the air and causes air pollution. There are many other gases present in air with oxygen. Today, the use of mineral oils has also increased. The vehicles running on fossil fuels, petrol and diesel, emit smoke and are harmful gases like hydrocarbon, nitrogen oxide, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide merges with the air, and the proportion of these gases in air has increased, which is harmful for our life. The proportion of CO2 has increased due to cutting of trees, which has led to intense problem of global warming. Why? Cutting of trees affect the increase of CO2 because trees inhale carbon dioxide and exhale oxygen. Human beings inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. Therefore, trees and human beings are parallel to each other. Trees inhale carbon dioxide and gives us oxygen. Therefore, we can get a good proportion of oxygen in air, whereas carbon dioxide becomes decreased. If we cut the trees and forest, there will be nothing that can inhale carbon dioxide and exhale oxygen. So we have to save trees and forest as much as we can. Deforestation is another reason behind the increase in air pollution. Deforestation means cutting down the forest. Dust particles float in air due to depletion of forest cover and trees. Dust particle can also affect our life. Air pollution causes various diseases such as asthma, breathing problems and lung infections. These all diseases are related to inhaling harmful gases. Dust particles floating in air lead to diseases like cold, cough and allergies. Skin allergies can all are also the reason for these dust particles. There have been instances when animal died due to suffocation caused by excess of pollution. Therefore, many of the animals and birds are extinct in today's world. The temperature of atmosphere has increased due to the pollution. As harmful gases are increasing in atmosphere, it also increases the temperature of the area. As we all know that we are experiencing 45 to 50 degrees Celsius temperature at the time of summer. To prevent air pollution, it is necessary to make certain rules for the industries and implement them strictly. First, we have known the causes of air pollution, then we study about the effects of air pollution, and now we are studying about the solution of air pollution. These all points are distributed in different paragraphs, and you can find out the answers related to these questions in your textbook easily. To make certain rules for industries, equipments that can filter smoke and harmful gas should be implemented in the industries. Industries has to follow the rules, or if they are not following it, they should be punished strictly by heavy fine or should be shut down. Environment awareness campaign should be organized. One should use petrol and diesel in judicious manner. Use pollution-free fuels like CNG and LPG gases, which helps to extend. Strict implementation on PUC in vehicle should be implemented. Your today's homework is to find out the full form of CNG, LPG and PUC and why it is important. So here we have learned about the air pollution, its causes, effects and solutions. The third and most important pollution which creates a great effect on human life is land pollution. Land pollution cannot be seen easily, but in this developing world, it causes a great effect on our life. We are dumping waste, industries waste, industrial waste, social waste, and polluting water on the land, which decreases the quality of that area. Growing industries and polluted water from drains flows on the ground and pollute the land, which affects its quality. The people who run industries and factories always try to acquire more land than what they require. According to them, they acquire more land for future development. When industries occupy the agricultural land, it surely pollutes it as the industrial solid waste on the land. Nowadays, plastic is used on large scale. Plastic is non-degradable substance. Non-degradable substance means we cannot destroy plastic in any manner. If we burn plastic, it becomes in liquid form. If we tear plastic, then also it is present at other form, but it is not destroyed properly. The urban waste like plastic, scraps, chemical dumps on land gets dispersed over the farmlands and destroy its quality. Wind carries these plastic scraps and other chemicals towards the other land and pollute them also. Farmers use chemical fertilizers to increase the production, and it also plays a major role in polluting the land and water. This agriculture product produced due to chemical fertilizer also affects the human life and make them ill. Polluted waters from industries and drainage is used in irrigation of fertile land, resulting in the polluted production of grains, vegetables cultivated on such land, which results into tuberculosis and bone diseases. Whatever agriculture is produced through this water and on this land, which cause human disease, that is tuberculosis and bone disease. Exhausted and shrinking fertile land leads to risk of scarcity of crops. Many crops cannot grow properly on this type of land. Land become barren due to destructions of microorganisms, which is destroyed by polluted water and chemicals. Land pollution can be controlled. We should use plastic and necessary chemicals judiciously. No industry should be set up on arable land, that means which is able to irrigate crops. We should conserve the environment. Use of organic and traditional manure, that is fertilizer, instead of chemical fertilizer. Pesticides should be used in minimum possible proportion. Pesticides means medicines which are used to save the crops from small insects. Use of non-conventional source of energy and green technologies. Drip irrigation saves water and prevents land degradation. Drip irrigation, in this type of irrigation facility, the water drops one by one onto the crop. So it saves much more water than sprinkling of water on the crops. Here we are completing our second part, which includes air pollution and land pollution. And you have to write all the questions related to these two topics in your work. Thank you.